Hey! Hey, you!
What's going on here?
What's it look like?
Get this truck out of here.
What do you think I'm trying to do?
Look, we're in the middle of a pour.
Yeah, well, tell me about it. This place is like an obstacle course around here.
Oh, boy. That's all I need. Rudy! Rudy, get these men to clear this pipe so I can get this truck out of here.
Gee, this guy's wrong. They have to end it.
Don't argue with me. Just do it.
Okay, okay. If you say so. Dominic. Pick up that pipe. Come on. You pick up the box.
That's all I need.
What in the hell's going on here?
Listen, Charlie, I've got a really big problem. I've got to get this pipe cleared so I can get the truck out of here.
You got a bigger problem with the local, Vic. You can't expect our men to lift pipe that size.
What am I going to do?
That's your problem. You're already responsible for one injury. There's no way any of my men on this job is going
to
manhandle.
No, listen, Charlie. If I take the time to get equipment here to move this, it's going to take up the whole day.
Again, that's your problem.
All the lousy, rotten luck.
Be reasonable. Come on, will you give us a break? You can't get blood out of a stone. Jack, we're in trouble. The number of delays, accidents, and injuries on that last job cost us a bundle. We can't afford another project like that.
Well, let's hope we don't have another run of bad luck.
Jack, it's more than bad luck. Me and our subs lost money on that because of all the holdups. We were almost 3 months late completing the job.
Like I said, it was bad luck.
I'm not sure it wasn't just plain bad management. Now, there must be ways to cut down on these holdups, and I think it's time we went looking for them.
Look, don't worry about it, Mike. I'm sure we're going to keep the costs down on this next contract.
How?
Well, for one thing, I'm going to keep on the same man and material horse I had in the last job.
Is it big enough?
Well, not as big as I'd like, but it'll do.
Yeah, and don't forget, I got a real deal on that job lot of concrete block.
But only if we accept the whole shipment, and that's going to jam up the site again.
We can still rent the vacant lot next to us.
Oh, at the price they're asking, forget it.
Listen, it'll take a little doing, but we can fit it all in.
Yeah, I can get tougher on the subs this time, make them keep a cleaner job.
Wait a minute. This sounds like exactly the way we went into the last job, and the job before that. We'll make do. We'll fit it in. It'll work somehow. And then something goes wrong, it always does, and then we blame our luck. I think it's time we started running the job instead of letting the job run us.
Okay, Mike, what do you suggest?
Take a look at this. I went through our weekly job reports on the last project. I made a list of all the delays and accidents that caused this time.
So what do you want me to do, read it and weep?
I want us to take a week and go around town and look at the job sites and see what they're doing that's different. Maybe we can get some ideas that'll help us out with our problem.
Look, Mike, if you're not satisfied with the way I run your jobs...
Vic, nobody's throwing stones at you. It's just that we've all been in this job so long, we think there's only one way to do things, our way. Now, maybe we do know what's best, but we've got a week to check around before we set up the next job. Why don't we take advantage of it?
Well, I think it's a waste of time.
Jack, if we bring in another contract like the last one, we're all of us going to have plenty of time to waste. Okay? Next week, same time?
Stewart gets in on the act, and that was it.
Took us till the end of the day to move that pipe and get that truck out of there.
Loose pipe is always a headache. Yeah? Bill, it's for you.
So you want to know how we handle loose pipe?
Fred, that's why I'm here.
How?
Okay, in the first place, we no longer accept loose pipe or fittings. Either they're palletized or, in the case of longer sections, bundled.
Our loading dock has leveling plates, so we can run a forklift or whatever right onto the truck. Our material hoist has a high gate, so the forklift can put the material directly onto the hoist. The hoist has a double door, so it's unloaded right on the floor and moved to where it's needed, all done mechanically. That way, we can deliver the material right to the floor where it's needed, all in one quick operation.
Yeah, we looked into that, but that kind of special equipment costs an arm and a leg. How do you justify it?
We can move more material. There's fewer men. We'll move it much faster.
Still don't think it makes up for the added cost.
We're bidding in competition with you for the same jobs. You're telling me you're losing money?
We're not, so we must be doing something right. What if a supplier sends you loose pipe anyway?
You refuse to accept it. They'll bundle it for you if you insist.
I'll tell you something else. Since we started using palletized and containerized materials, our accident and injury rate has been cut by more than half.
So if you're worried about lost time and wasted man hours, I can't think of a better place to start.
Maybe you got a point there, Fred.
Mr. Anderson.
Sure, you got enough?
Sure thing.
Great.
What are you doing here, Mike?
Well, I'm curious about a few things.
Oh, yeah? What?
Joe, from your point of view as a crane operator, could you tell me why we had so much trouble on that last job?
Well, sometimes it goes well, sometimes not.
Yeah, well, that time it didn't. I'd like to find out why.
Well, I'll be frank with you. I never was on a job before where I had to move things so often to make room for something else I didn't know was coming. If there had been a schedule that told me when something major is going to be delivered, I could clear a space for it in advance. You remember the refrigeration stuff? The day they brought that in, nobody had told me until it got there.
I didn't know that.
I had to stop lying farms to unload the truck, which was really too far from the building for my crane to lift the load safely.
Why not?
The truck couldn't get any closer. There was a pile of concrete blocks in the way. I don't know what they were doing there. We didn't need them.
My brother got a deal on that.
So I had to move the blocks to get the truck in close enough to unload. And you know the rest, don't you?
Yeah. It was 6 weeks before we got the thing back from the factory in working condition.
Could have been worse. You're lucky nobody got killed.
Yeah, that was close.
Well, too close. It makes no sense to stop in the middle of one job because something has to be moved or unloaded unexpectedly. People tries to hurry in, that's when accidents happen, you know that.
Well, the problem was it wasn't a big enough job for two cranes. There were times we sure could have used one.
Why didn't you bring in a mobile crane when you needed it?
Vic and my brother talked about that, but they didn't think we could justify the expense. But when you think about the number of guys that were standing around doing nothing, if we'd hired the extra crane for the day, it would have been cheaper.
Right on.
Yeah.
I know you think I got a lot of nerve asking you a fellow contractor for advice.
Well, you realize, of course, it's going to cost you.
Well, what do you think?
Okay. Well, if what you tell me is true, I'd say you guys are underplanned, undersold.
That's not true. We know exactly where we're supposed to be on any given day.
Problem is, you're not getting there, right?
But this job was an exception.
And you can't afford another exception. Jack, come on. You wouldn't be asking my advice.
We were bound to run into bad luck on a job.
Jack, luck has very little to do with it if you plan properly. Let me give an example. Right now, Dietrich Randall, you remember him, my project manager, is having a weekly scheduling meeting with our subs.
Okay, men, then we all agree to take 1 week to complete each typical floor, no more. So, Larry, next Friday afternoon at 3, you will bring in 2 containers of flex and fittings and be ready to start the 3rd floor on Monday morning. Place the containers in this area and be sure to keep these areas clear for access at all times. By the following Friday afternoon, you have to be finished and the area cleaned up so that Tony can move in. Tony, how much stuff do you have to bring in for the heating and cooling systems?
We'll have 14 containers of fittings for the 7 floors. The basic pipe was lifted earlier by the crane and racked in Zone B on each floor.
Okay. 2 weeks from Monday at 8 a.m., you will bring in 2 containers for the 3rd floor. Larry will be starting on the 4th at that time.
It'd be better for me if I brought in all the fittings at the same time, Dietrich.
Better for you, maybe, but not for the rest of us. It would just be in everybody's way and slow us all down.
But I've got a storage problem, Dietrich.
Then you'll just have to solve it some other way. We can't finish a floor a week if there's another sub's men and material in the way. That's the deal.
Arthur, you figure four containers of sheet metal fittings and three pallets of ductwork for flooring? Okay, we'll schedule a hoist from 8:30 to 9 Monday morning, here. Sven, you'll bring in your containers of sprinkler fittings for the third floor only on the Monday morning following Arthur's crew. Remember now, everything that goes up on that material hoist has to be either palletized or in containers so our forklift or pallet trucks can handle it. If there's any material or junk left on the floor after you move out, we'll clean it up and we'll back charge you for the time. Any questions? Let's get to work.
How do you get away with it? I mean, if we talk to our subs like that, I'm sure they'd walk right off the job.
You'd be surprised, Jack. We met a little resistance at first, but when the guys saw things were going faster and better, they bought it.
I don't know, Ben. It may work for you, but...
Okay, let me ask you this. What do you think is the single greatest cause for delay?
I don't know I could name a single cause. Accidents, injuries, materials not showing up on time.
Arriving too early, cluttering up the place?
Yeah, I guess so.
Well, it's all part of the same thing, Jack. Materials. Whenever you have an accident or an injury, many times it's in the handling of materials. Now, how many times have you been held up because you couldn't get things through the way they were needed?
But let's face it, Ben, that's part of this business.
Only if you let it be. Now, if you start insisting that deliveries be made at an exact time to a specific drop point on the site where things are going to be used, and if you start scheduling things so that nothing, but nothing comes on that job that hasn't been planned for in advance, you're a long way towards solving your problems.
What are you telling me? I can eliminate foul-ups entirely?
Don't we wish. But if you did that, you'd be outbidding us on every job, and I'd be coming to you for advice. I only want you to stay in business.
Looks good.
I've talked to all the subs, and they promise their full cooperation.
And the guy with the vacant lot next door? I was able to get his price down a little. Not as much as I'd like, but a little.
Okay. I see you put on the extra crane for the peak periods.
Mm-hmm. And I've arranged for a loading dock and ramp, forklifts, a hoist with double doors, and the engine control, a whole bit.
Great. And no loose materials on the site. Everything that comes on must be containerized, palletized, or bundled. Right, brother?
Right on.
A time and a place for everything.
Hello, Frank. Roger here.
Yes, Roger.
We'll have to change the schedule on you. Second load of rebar won't be in until 4 o'clock. We'll move the glass people up in their place at 2. How's that?
Yeah, that'll work all right.
Okay. Thanks, Mike.
Let's go get them. We got lots to do.